linear, and we can make it into one. So number 10, here's what we start with. We start with y minus 1 times the sine of x dx. And then we have minus dy, and that whole thing is equal to 0. So I go back and I look at my dy over dx plus p of x times y plus equals q of x. That is not what I have right there, is it? So then the next question to ask is, well, can I manipulate it into that form? So let's see if we can manipulate it into the form that we need. First of all, let's distribute. So we're going to have sine of x times y minus sine of x, and all of that goes with the dx. The dy I'm going to move to the other side. And then I'm just going to divide out this dx, because that'll give me my dy dx that I need, correct? Mm-hmm. Okay. So we've got sine of x times y minus sine of x is equal to dy dx, right? So we need the dy dx by itself, and that needs to be added to some function in x multiplied by y, right? On the left-hand side, do we have some function in x that's multiplied by y? Yeah. So we're going to take this. We're going to move it over here to the other side. When we move it, we have to remember to change the sign, correct? Because we're really subtracting it. So here's how I'm going to write it. I'm going to write it this way to make it look like the form I want. There's my dy dx. And I'm going to make this plus negative sine of x times y. Okay. Do I have dy dx by itself? Yes. Okay. Is that added to some function that's just in x multiplied by y? Yes. And is the other side of the equation just some function in x? Yes. So does this now fit the form of a first order linear equation? Yes. All right, once we have identified the form and we've made sure we're in the right form, what was our next step? To find the mu, the integrating factor. So to find mu, I take E and I raise it to what power? The integration of negative sine. Okay. If I integrate negative sine, what do I get?
Cosine.
Cosine. So this is going to be e to the cosine x. After we find the integrating factor, what do we do with it? We multiply on both sides. So we're going to have, look at the order I wrote this in. We're going to have negative sine x times e to the cosine x. And that is going to equal e to the cosine x dy dx
plus e to the cosine x times negative sine x, and all of that is multiplied by y. Now remember that we said one side's going to force the product rule. This side is our product rule. So really we're looking at the derivative with respect to x of what product? What's our f? And what's our g? Just plain old cosine x? E to the cosine x. Because what's the derivative of e to the cosine x? E to the cosine x. And then come back and take the derivative of cosine, so that's your negative sine. So this is f. This is f prime, right? If you're labeling. What's g? G is just your y. And so what's g prime? Dy dx. So our product is e to the cosine x times y. And on the other side, we have negative sine x e to the cosine x. Any questions up to this point? We're going to integrate both sides. So on this side, we have e to the cosine x times negative sine x, and we are integrating with respect to x. On the other side, we're just integrating that derivative. What do I get when I integrate e to the cosine x times negative sine x? I just get e to the cosine x. My u here is cosine x. My du then would be negative sine. So I'm really just integrating e to the u du, right? So it ends up being e to the u. So this side is just going to be e to the cosine x. On the other side, I just get that product. And so remember, our product was just e to the cosine x times y, plus a constant, of course. Is it easy to get y by itself here? Yeah, what do we do? Okay, so we just divide by our e to the cosine x. So this would give us a 1. This would give us y plus c over e to the cosine x. And then if I were going to get y by itself, I would move that to the other side. So I would say 1 minus, you can say plus if you want to because c is arbitrary. Okay, any questions?
I have a question.
Go ahead.
What if you would put the plus c on the other side?
You can do that. That's fine.
But then you would have 1 plus c.
But c is an arbitrary constant. It could be positive or negative.
Okay.
So it doesn't matter.
Okay.
Doesn't matter. Any other questions? Okay. Y'all are a good class. You paid attention well today. You've